The one thing I hate about Destiny cats is that they're all so feminine, and I hate them. Just by the way they look, basically, everything is feminine about them. Just look at them. But that's probably just, oh my, get off. That's just probably because of the, of how used to feminine designs I am, I guess. But that is the crisis today, and we are going to avert it by making a LPS Destiny cat custom, and I'm going to order a base off of eBay for as cheap as I can get it. I'm gonna try to get the ugliest one I can find, or the one in the worst condition, so I can customize it into a male Destiny cat, because I really want my mascot to be a male Destiny cat. I don't know what it is about them. They also don't have the best bobble, so you're like, why the frick would you like a Destiny cat? Well, because I do. So get out. All right, let's start with our first step, and that is making the design. So I'll be seeing you on my iPad screen recording. Woo! Oh my god, it's voice over me. Okay, so basically, you need a design, obviously, before you even start with your freaking custom, because, you know, you need to get your bases done. So obviously, the easiest way to achieve that is by grabbing a drawing app. I'm using Procreate, and then draw out and trace your pet, and then color it, add on your little, like, add-on things. This is what I'm doing because I have access to epoxy sculpt. So yeah, that I'm adding fluff, I'm adding a bunch of whatever. So yeah. By the way, remember to go as far out as you think you can do, if that makes sense. Because if you mess up, that's not my fault, that's your fault because you're bad. I shouldn't say that, actually. Oh my god. So this ended up being my final design. So now I'm ready to start customizing. So as a rational person would, you open up Amazon, look for that cat, wait for that MF to load, and it loads, woo! And then I find one that's one day shipping and add it to my cart and place the order. And I'll be back in a day when the cat's here, so.
It's here.
Oh my god. Oh, it's cold. What the hell?
Oh, okay. Why is it?
Whoa! Oh my lordy lord. Okay, let's go.
Open this baby up.
Okay, so this is my little workshop. It's really dark, but who cares? So I have the package right here, and let's open it and get what's inside. It's over here. And get what's inside. Ah!
Another bag. Ooh.
Open it up. All right. She is here. Oh my god, it's a good one. Oh, thank god. Hopefully she bobbles. She bobbles. Oh my god. Yes. Yes. Here's the authentic mold and here's the fake. It's good enough. And I'm happy. I'm very happy. Okay. Yes, we got a good one. Yes. So I'm a little guilty of changing the design that I showed already in the video, but here it is. I think it's much better. It's like a calico, but it looks like two different cats, which I think is pretty cool. So hopefully I'm able to at least get the clay done today. But first let's prep her. So to start prep off, what you're gonna need is alcohol prep wipes to make sure your LPS is completely cleaned. Then you're gonna need some nail polish remover. I don't think mine's 100% acetone, which is probably what you need. Like pure acetone. Let's see. Well, whatever. Q-tips to, you know, put the acetone on and stuff. So let's start. So start off with just, you probably only need one alcohol prep wipe. Sorry if you can't hear me very well, but you probably can. And just wipe down all that dirt off. It'll get very... I don't think it'll be too dirty, but it's supposed to keep your thing clean so your base coat doesn't cling onto anything. Gross. All right, next. Pour some, keep it away from children. It's extremely flammable. So take a cap of nail polish. You can't see it. Just a cap's enough. And then you're just gonna use your Q-tips. And I don't think mine is strong enough to get rid of factory paint. Oh, there it goes, it spilled. Okay, fantastic. Wonderful. But you can start washing it away with your Q-tip. I don't think mine's strong enough. It's definitely not strong enough. But it is in the instructions to use gloves. Oh, it's only to measure. Oh, I'm stupid. Look at this, to measure equal parts. Oh my God, I'm stupid. I've been using gloves and it's been so hard, but now I know. So I'm gonna start by looking at my reference picture, which is in the back. You can kind of see it, of how much I need. I need some for the tail. I'll show you. I need some for the tail fluff, the ears at the top and the sides. So I probably don't need that much. All right. Then we're gonna mix part A and part B. All right. Now that it's all mixed together, I'm gonna get a protective surface for my thing. So I'm gonna use this little mat I have. Hold on. So I have my LPS here. And leave this for 5 minutes. I'm gonna set a timer on my iPad. It's usually 5 to 15. So I'm gonna go for right in the middle and do 10 minutes. So I'll be back in 10 minutes. Okay, so a nice thing to have while you're working with epoxy is water is your best friend, and it's gonna keep it smooth. So let's already get started. So I'm gonna start probably with the ears, or no, actually I'm gonna do the ears last. I'm gonna do the tail first maybe, and then work upwards. Oh my God, it's me in a voiceover again. So basically what I did is I just grabbed little pieces of clay and I just smudged them on there with water to smooth it out. As I said, water's your best friend. So it got to the point where I couldn't reach it with my sausage fingers, so I grabbed a clay tool and I just worked on it and smoothed it out that way. That is the first part of my little sculpting. The tail is definitely the hardest part because you have to go in like under the neck and stuff, but I'm just glad we can finally move on to the face, which is one of my favorite parts to sculpt. Little fluffs on the side. I hope I don't mess it up as much as I did with the last one, so hopefully this goes well. It honestly went fine, but it was definitely the part that took me the longest to get done. It was mostly because of the really tiny parts I had to like sculpt in and hopefully like blend into the smoothness, but yeah, that's all. Okay, so I just finished the sides. That took the longest. It took longer than the tail, which actually ultimately has more parts, but it was mostly the small side, the top ones that were taking the most time out of me. So yeah. So far, he looks amazing. I am so excited to see how he turns out because I'm smiling because I'm so happy. I really want this to work out and I'll make it work out. Yeah, but I really like how it looks, the smoothness, the sleekness of it. But if it ends up all right, especially with how good I'm doing with the sculpting, usually ear cuffs make the ears look extremely tall. It definitely did in the drawing, but I know it'll turn out well, and I trust in myself. So, here's a time lapse of the ear tufts. I'm back with the voiceover. So the ear fluff at the top was probably the easiest. Actually, no, it wasn't. It was hard to work with because of how smooth it was. It was really hard to add the fluff at the other side, or like at the bottom of the ear, because it had to be so small. But the ears kind of look like a koala. The koala molds. Oh my God, can I talk? But like overall, I think I did pretty good for whatever I was doing. Okay, so as you can see, I finished with the sculpting. It's definitely quite something. I definitely think I went a little too big on the ears, but it's okay. So here it is, finished. Yeah. This is the custom.
clay job all done. I definitely wish I could add more or make the tail droop down, but I'd have to cut through thick plastic. Like the tail is quite big, so I'd have to cut through some hella plastic just to get to it. So I'm gonna quickly try to fix up little details and I'll be back. Okay, so I did as much as I can without like absolutely destroying it. I smoothed out the ears. I pushed them down a little bit. But here is the final sculpt, and it says on the epoxy sculpt instructions, by 24 hours it will be hard, cured, and waterproof. So now I have to wait 24 hours for it to cure, and we can finally get to painting the best part. I'm really happy with this so far.
I'll see you when it's fully cured. Sorry, I took a break so I could finish with the rest of my extras. So I have a this is completely off topic with the video, but we have two little tickets. These are little concert tickets for this commission I'm doing. And then we have a collar. I'm gonna attempt to make a collar, a pillow, and then a bunch of cookies. But I'll be back with you when this little guy is cured. But I think it's been about an hour and a half ish. It's already pretty hardened. Like, I can still mold it a little bit, but I think by the time it's like 10 p.m. or 9, right now it's 7:44, it will be decently cured enough for me to start painting. I'm probably gonna start painting at like 9, since I probably will go to sleep at like 11 or 12. So yeah, I'll be back in like 2 hours and we'll see how everything is. Yeah, or the next day, because the sun is setting.
It's 9 and I think it's time. It's hard enough to paint on, so I'm gonna start it.
Is it time lapse?
It is nearly 1 a.m. so I'm gonna be really quiet with this voiceover, but basically what I'm doing here is I'm making a lot of layers of this cream color so I can get the base color down, and then I'll work on the details later. So I'm not gonna talk a lot for these, so you can just enjoy the music.
I'm pausing my LPS Hannah binge, outsiders. But here is the base, it's cream base. So let's get into the black and brown details.
I will say that the details were a bit difficult to plaster on there because I both had to layer it and I also had to stay clean, because it'd be a little difficult to get like the harsh brown and black off of a cream base.
Ignore the noise in the back, but after like an hour or two
hours of painting, it's 11:07 and I have completed the actual paint itself. Did run into some slopes, especially with color matching, but here it is. There's still some parts I have to finish up, but the main part now is the eyes. I will say that it was pretty difficult to blend the eyes the way I wanted it to, but it was my first time doing it, so I don't blame myself for it being bad. But yeah, I added small little details, and all that was needed after I was finished was just a little bit of sealant and some gloss on the eyes. It was definitely a roller coaster. There's still some stuff I wish I could fix, but I guess I can. You can't have everything perfect. I really like the front, the face. Oh, it's adorable. And I really like how I got the glossy eyes without like smudging the paint itself. Like, I used a top coat on this and it's like literally the same amount of
shine as the matte Mod Podge I used. It's kind of sad. But I'm glad I finally got this one to work out. And I said I'd make it work. It does still look like a koala, but I don't mind too much. Maybe in the future change some things, but right now I don't really care too much. But yeah, that's it. Thank you for joining me in this LPS custom journey. I'll see you soon.